The following program is brought to you by Greater Exodus Baptist Church. Now here is today's message.
Some people had their station on 6 and heard the weatherman say that it's going to be difficult today. And they just roll over in bed. But the folk that are here, they heard the weatherman and said, I know someone who controls the weather. Somebody in here just pushed their way through. You know, that's how you get your blessing. Am I right about it? Turn to your neighbor and say, neighbor, if you want to be blessed, you got to learn how to push through it. Say, push, neighbor.
And when he fumbled the ball, he went back on the bench and he sat down and put his head down. And somehow the defense got the ball back. And one of the coaches was talking to the head coach and said, what we gonna do? He fumbled the ball. We can't depend on him. What you gonna do, coach? And I overheard the coach say, where is he? Go get him. Put him back in the game and give him the ball. I want you to know something. That young boy was me. Are you hearing what I'm saying? I fumbled, but the coach gave me the ball. Now let me bring it home to you. You have fumbled. But oh glory, you missed the mark. You come short of the glory of God, but you are alive right now because the big coach of Sam said, don't kill him. You ever heard the ball? Yeah! You got the ball. Now what you gonna do with it? I'm gonna shout with the ball. I'm gonna run with the ball. I'm gonna jump with the ball. alright. He's 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 alright. When I think about Jesus, what he's done for me, when I think about Jesus, all they said this way. Beat your drum, play your organ, open your mouth, jump and shout.
Many times.
Amen.
And
some things happened and he couldn't come. And I just figured something was going to happen again and he was not coming. And so I paid no attention to it until I got that phone call. And oh, how blessed we are to have him with us. So how shall I introduce him to you? I say to you, my friends, that a tall cedar is in this place, in the person of my father. Not simply because he's my father, but because over the years, I have seen patience, love, temperance, not only for his family, but I've seen it for all the people who come in contact with his presence. Here's a man who loves God. Here's a man who's a builder. Here's a man who built a church, who went into a church and became a literal carpenter. Began to build his church with his own hands. Oh yes, this is the man I'm talking about right here. A man that is crazy for Jesus. And that when he get a vision, you give him a vision and a hammer and look at him. And here's what I mean by that. Dad, we come to church some Sundays and a whole wall would be torn down. Because Dad had a vision. Because he figured we needed more space. We didn't know we needed more space, but he knew we needed more space. So he tore down the walls while we were sleeping at night. I'm talking about a man with a vision. I'm talking about a man who has over and over and over and over again taught me the importance of love and forgiveness. Amen. I mean, I learned how to love by watching him love people who were his enemies. Amen. I never forget the day one of his deacons said to him, when Dad was trying to stand up and be what God would call him to do, one of his deacons said to him, "You can leave if you want to." And told my dad, "Let the door hit you." What a dog bitch. And I saw my dad love that man. I saw my dad love that man and his family, unfortunately, all the way to the grave. This man has taught me how to love my enemies. This man has taught me how to do good to them that spitefully use me. This man has taught me how never to give up on a human being. That what they are right now is not what they're going to be later on. Give God a chance.
This concludes part one. Please resume this message at part two.